yesterday. All my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Some shadow. Seems to be a safe attached. Hey, watch it up there!
Now it's time for Joe Alaskey's bad casting. Okay, these are all the right actors in all the wrong roles. And let's start off with a very talented guy who used to be very popular back with the old Andy Griffith Show and then later on with Three's Company. Of course, I'm referring to... Don Knotts. I know the resemblance is incredible, but please, hold it down. Nevertheless, here he is, Don Knotts, as we've never seen him before. Don Knotts as Abraham Lincoln.
Well, 4 score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth in this here continent a new nation. Conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal.
Thank you, Don. Our 16th president, Don Knotts. Thank you.
I started off with Looney Tunes, I guess you'd have to say, in the movies. I was in Who Framed Roger Rabbit as Yosemite Sam, coming over the wall saying, "My biscuits is burning." Remember that?
Ow! My biscuits are burning! Fire in the hatch! Oh, ooh, green hornet toads, that's smarts!
I'm seen on Tiny Toons currently, and soon to star in his own show on the Fox affiliate is the Plucky Duck Show. I play Plucky Duck,
who's a little green duck about this high, and very egotistical, very obnoxious, and of course he is the person who is getting his own show.
You're lucky, it's Plucky.
I'm absolutely ducky.
Other shows seem yucky now that Plucky's on the air.
In Plucky's case, he was obviously Daffy Duck. But with Daffy, they said, we want the same voice. I mean, with Plucky, we want the same as Daffy's voice, but different. So I said, oh, well, that's typical Hollywood. What do I do with that?
So I just moved it from a frontal lisp to a lateral lisp.
Every afternoony, I'm invading your TV.
I'm Babsy.
I'm Plucky.
I work with him, I'm lucky.
For Tiny Toons, I won the best performance by a duck and me. Well, I'm Plucky Duck and I'm a zany megastar. There's lots of other Tiny Toons, but who cares who they are?
So watch, won't you? Dave will watch.
Guess who discovered me?
Steven Spielberg.
Bullwinkle.
When it comes to humility, I'm the greatest!
Bill Scott was the guy's name, and he kind of plucked me out of Albany before I was Plucky. And he had me do voice of Boris Badenov, which I still do for instance, certain commercials you will hear on television.
Yeah, get you make Boris burgers!
Burger is so boring, grass growing is exciting!
What if I just ask you, who's your favorite Looney Tune?
Okay. Who is it? Sylvester.
Sylvester? Well, he's one of my favorites, too. He's always after a little yellow bird who looks sort of like this with a face.
This furball, my lad, is the Hall of Cartoon Pussycats. Enshrined here are the greatest stars of feline comedy. Stars like Helix, Garfunkel, Tom Injury, and last but not least, moi.
Someday I'll eat that darn canary, and then I'll be happy, yes siree.
What Hector thinks you should be wary.
Sylvester McTweedy, mysteries.
Lunch is served.
You can't eat me, Putty Tack.
You're right. And you know why, my fine feathered friend?
It's not in my contract.
No, because a sandwich just isn't a sandwich without the tangy... Yeah!
What's eating him?
So whose voice do you do?
Yours.
Well, keep practicing. Where is this guy? I mean, what kind of a jerk shows up 2 hours late?
Dodgers, the agent is prepared to be evaporated up to your ship. Now remember, we're counting on you. This mission is of the utmost import. You represent the entire...
Blah, 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 blah. All right, cadet, let's bring this knucklehead aboard. Evaporate! All right, pal, let's get one thing straight. I love you with every fiber of my being.
And the name goes to Joe Alaskey as Buck Rogers.
Speechless, right? Wow. You know, they're right. This does feel fantastic and sensational and almost humbling.
So, do I have the job?
Well, wait a second. I can hire you. You're a duck.
What are you trying to say here? You don't hire ducks?
Well, if you were a jackass, maybe. Then you could run the place. But, but a duck? No.
That's a blatant example of discrimination. Whatever happened to affirmative action? I don't see any ducks around here.
Well, what are your qualifications?
You want qualifications? I got them coming out the wazoo. I got an MBA, a PhD, an EKG, a BLT, a TNT, and a big old load of TLC.
You stole my duck.
Your duck? Bah! I belong to the world.
You know what? You can have him.
Mike. Look how dynamite!
Welcome to my world.
Hark! The door! Oh, for joy! It's a missive from the Intergalactic Court of Last Resort. They're finally going to hear my case against the planet Earth. They've blasted us from all sides with rocket ships and whatnot, sullied up our nice universe with stinky pollution, portrayed us as monsters, and fabricated entertainment spectacles about destroying us. Well, now we get to blow them up. But it has to look legal.
I say, I say, big wheels keep on turning. Travel me home to see my kin. Yeah. Singing songs about the Southland. I'm with my Alabama once again. I think it's a sin, yeah.
Like the end, doesn't it? You're probably waiting for your life to flash before your eyes. Well, we've got a little surprise for you. Calamity Coyote, this was your life. I'm your host, Wile E. Coyote. Super genius. Yes, Calamity, in just a few seconds you'll be street pizza. But before you cash in your chips, let's review your life and see where you went astray, shall we?
Well, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And it seems we've no place to go. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow!
There's no unusual way to say Merry Christmas in a card. No way!
Oh, see, there is, Señor Pato Lucas.
Wash your lips there, shorty pants. You're so smart. What's the new way to say Merry Christmas?
Feliz Navidad.
Felix Navidad?
Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad.
Easy for you to say. You try it.
I would like to know what Bugs Bunny thinks about Hillary Clinton.
And what Bugs Bunny thinks about Hillary Clinton, I think that she's probably got as good a shot at the presidency as Elmer Fudd does.
Smash the rabbit, make it a habit. I've got a lot of what it takes to change the law. I'm in for money, the money.
Eh.
What's up, Duck? What's up, Ebbett? I'll tell you what's up. When I'm president, I'm gonna pass a law that'll outlaw rabbits. That, my poor, unfortunate, soon-to-be-condemned species, is what is up.
It's a sad state of affairs, I tell you, when the noblest of woodland creatures can be defamed and degraded in such a derogatory fashion. Why, if I couldn't draw me a better wolf than that, I'd hand in my beret. Allow me to introduce myself. Name's Thomas T. Wolf. Thomas, after my daddy, and T for... Timber!
I am Oz, the great and powerful!
So are you enjoying yourself in our nation's capital, young man?
Yes, sir.
Well, where are you staying?
It's called the Hotel Ebbett. Oh, no. I know of a much nicer hotel. It's brand new, very modern. I'll have my people take care of it for you.
Fabulous riches! A chance to impress the big boss! I had it all in my grasp, and I blew it!
Hey, Death, we're all going to the Dolby to celebrate Tweety's new movie deal. Wanna come?
Never mind me. I've got a date with the worms. If they'll even have me.
Come on, we got worms back in Boy Bank. You sure you don't want a ride?
A ride? What's it gonna cost me?
Don't worry, Death. I'll cut you a special deal.
You want how much?
Parting is such sweet sorrow.